Polypop is the software that I can't seem to shut up about. I previously described it as OBS but in 3D. The truth is, it's way more than that. It's OBS plus a bunch of OBS plugins plus StreamerBot plus stream elements and everything in just one software that runs on a game engine. So you're allowed to do 2D stuff and you're also allowed to do 3D stuff. Anyways, the whole goal of Polypop is basically to boost interaction with your community, basically. It allows your viewers to control a bunch of stuff, and it lets your imagination run wild when it comes to setting up all that cool stuff. So it's not just a broadcasting software where you would put your camera and then a game capture and then that's it, and everything you have to go through like other services or whatever. No, it connects to your Twitch channel and gives you access to so many things. So your imagination is really the only limit that you're gonna get. Anyways, today I just wanna show you how easy it is to get into it and to start streaming. I'm gonna show you a basic setup, and I'll also share some tips here and there. The cool thing is this video is sponsored by Polypop, so we can jump right into it. Go to polypoplive.com and then download it. So first thing we're gonna see here is the basic broadcasting software layout, right? We're gonna have our scenes up top, so we can, if we wanna switch, we can just click on them. Here, this big gray area is basically the preview, which you can actually change the background color of. Under scene layout is what we would call like the sources or the layers. And then underneath that is the properties for said layer. So you click on something, the scene is counted actually as a source, if you will. At the bottom, we're gonna have some crucial buttons about your platform because it's compatible with both Twitch and YouTube. You're gonna have your record button if you just wanna use it as a recorder, live stream buttons, virtual camera buttons, and then we're gonna have output mix so you can keep an eye on your audio. Now there's one thing that sets it apart a little bit is that it has a library. So if I go and I click bottom left here on open library, this is going to be a list of assets that you can add, and then you can choose to put them on your scenes or not. The advantage here is that you get a better look at what is on your scenes, basically. So for example, if I want to switch out my webcam and I don't want to go scene by scene and click on the source, and I can just switch my webcam asset that's in the library. Talking about webcams, let's add one. Just like any other software, you click on the big plus to add something, and then we're gonna scroll down all the way to webcam, click, and it's gonna find a webcam. You can click on the drop down to switch the webcam if it's not the right one, but you're gonna see active, resolution, all of that. Basically, this is where you're gonna have the properties for whatever you click on in the library. From there, I can add the webcam to my scene, but I can choose exactly how I wanna add it. I could add it in 2D, like a regular broadcasting software, but this is Polypop we're talking about. So we can go click on plus under the scene layout, and we can find a 3D object where I can use the webcam as a texture. There's a bunch of pre-made ones, and you can actually create your own or download some from the internet, modify them a little bit, boom, put them in Polypop. There's a rounded corner one here. I'm gonna add that and click add. From there, since it has a texture to it, it's gonna ask me, hey, do you wanna use like that webcam that you added? And I click yes, okay, boom. Now I have it, and I can click and drag to switch the position. But I also have at the bottom here, when I click on webcam, I'm gonna have transform. And transform means that I can move it. Yes, in 3D space, I can rotate it in 3D space, but let's scale it up a little bit, just like that. And I'm gonna actually rotate it a little bit also, that side. Nice, the borders have a color that I can actually pick. You know the color scheme, purple, teal, always. And we're gonna put that somewhere over there. There's a weird line going on here, but I'm guessing that's because of the depth. So I can go to position and there you go. Place it a little outwards like that. I like it. Now, if you watch my videos, you know that I like flipping the camera so that I'm looking at the content and not at this wall that is outside. It's a weird feeling. So I can go in my library and I can just flip this horizontally, not vertically. There you go. Now it looks like I'm gonna be reacting to whatever video game. Talking about video game, how do I add a game capture? Open the library, click on plus, find app slash screen capture. Boom, under source, I can pick exactly which one I wanna capture. I have VR chat open right now with an avatar of myself, and now it's in my library. Boom, I can add it as 2D or 3D. Let's go click on plus and make up our minds while we're there. I actually like the rounded corner a lot. I kind of really wanna add that again, but there are things like TVs, there are some models that are pretty cool here that I might wanna use, but I do want something flat like this maybe. What does that look like? Yeah, that looks pretty cool. It's gonna ask me what texture you wanna use. Boom, that, cool, cool, cool. Again, bottom under transform, I can move the scale. There you go. And I'm just gonna place it and also rotate it. I'm even creating like shadows on it, which is an option that you can actually turn off here if you don't want it to cast, like if you don't want the webcam to cast shadows, you can turn that off, boom. Now there's a ton of things that you can add, but I want to keep it simple. What I'm going to do is I'm actually going to change the background color a little bit. I'm going to click on the scene and I'm going to go to color and I'm going to make this like a dark blue maybe, just to give the illusion that it's more customized than it actually is. Now, technically I could say, hey, we're ready to stream. We probably want to create another scene, but we need something like alerts. And since I said Polypop would do all of that good stuff, what we can do is go to the library, click plus, go to Twitch alerts, and here it's going to ask you to connect to Twitch. And you're going to do just that. It's going to bring up a Twitch page. You're going to click authorize and then boom, here you're going to have access to everything. Stats is basically triggers that you can basically, you know, drag and drop in order to create some actions. So username would be like if a specific person shows up, drop a bunch of gold coins or show their name on screen or something like that. Follower count, if you reach a certain follower count, you can play an alert for that. Subscriber count, bits tally, and that's just stats, right? Alerts, of course, we're gonna have new follower, if someone types something in chat, subscription, bits, raids. Cheer alerts, gonna be specific number of bits, channel points where you can create and also manage channel points directly from here, and of course, you know, make them trigger whatever you want. Chat alerts on keywords, chat commands, and stuff like that. For example, because I'm talking about this, there's multiple ways of doing this, but I'm gonna do something simple. Let's say Twitch bits here. I'm gonna add this as a object emitter. I'm not trying to confuse you, but you can add objects as particle emitters, right? And I'm gonna click emit burst. And I'm gonna have a bunch of biddies and I can change the burst count. I can make it like be a lot. I can change the gravity. I can change the velocity. I can do a lot. And since everything is 3D, I can make it actually interact with each other. I could make bits like bounce off of my webcam. I could make my webcam attract all the biddies with specific alerts that I choose from. But here's the thing, if this seems complicated to you, what you must know is that there's tutorials on Polypop directly, just like a game. You can click on starting points here and then go to in-app tutorials and it will teach you how the basic stuff works. Step by step, it will teach you how to use it, which every software should have that. Anyways, so I created my animation, okay? It's gonna be emit burst, basically when I click here. This is what's gonna happen. And I want that to happen on something specific. You can click open library and I can go to Twitch alerts and then under the alert that I want, something's gonna happen. For example, bits, gain amount, 500 bits. I'm gonna click on this little circle here and I'm gonna drag it and drop it to emit burst. It's not the only way to do this, but I'm just showing you right now. And I can test it. So every time I get 500 bits, boom, I'm gonna have that sort of animation. Of course, you should spend more time on this. All right, now I'm gonna duplicate my scene real quick and I wanna show you something that is kind of known as the move transition plugin, but it's not a plugin here, it's integrated into Polypop. So on my scene, I'm gonna right click and I'm gonna click copy. I'm gonna right click over here and I'm gonna click paste. I actually created another scene. I'm gonna double click on the scene name. I'm gonna click press 2, nice. And I can show up everything that's in there. From scene 2, I can move things around, right? Let's say that this is my just chatting scene, right? And I want it to be, you know, I want this to be bigger. I would want this to be, whoops, closer to the camera like this maybe, or just bigger with the scale, right? But I want my game to be smaller. I think that's pretty good. As you can see, it's running so smoothly. Anyways, all right, played around with it a little bit. And now when it emits, it does that. Now we're gonna add a transition between those two scenes, because scene 1, scene 2, just chatting in game basically, right? I'm gonna make sure my scene is selected here on the scene 1. I'm gonna click plus and I'm gonna go to transitions. Up here, if you hover, it's going to say creates a transition effect when switching scenes. I'm gonna click on this, I'm gonna click add, boom, and that's it. And now if we look top right, we're gonna see our transition is added to our global scene. With transition selected, we can pick the style. And here we're gonna go for tween. And as you can see, there's stinger, there's luma fade, crossfade, there's a lot. Let's click on scene 2. And as you can see, it readjusts, including the bits, because I made like the gravity force to be different on the bits, so it just adjusts. Let's go back. There you go. Now, if you are connected to Twitch, you're gonna see at the bottom here, live stream with the Twitch logo. You can hover over it and click on the little edit button. And this is where we're gonna have your settings, basically. Your stream settings, configure resolution. I can click on configure, boom. And I'm gonna have, you know, 720p, 30fps. If I go back here and I click on it again, I'm gonna have what type of encoder. You have your video bitrate that you can pick, your audio bitrate. You can even pick the service if you want to switch to something else. Facebook Live is available. YouTube Live is available. You can just switch just like that. If you want to record, you will also have some record options while you're streaming. If you want to save the stream, basically create your own VOD on your hard drive, boom, you can do it here. Another cool thing to know about Polypop is that it's always saving you. Everything you're doing here, everything I'm doing here is saved. I'm not scared of losing it, right? But on top of that, I can extra save it into a file if I want to give it to someone, for example, right? If you click here, you're going to have a save as and package as. Package as means that if I create some overlays or some cool 3D objects and I want to share that with someone, I can click package as and it will create a file that will have all the assets integrated into it. Can you imagine what that means? That means that I can create stuff and just share it with you, which is something that I was supposed to do right now, right here on this video. But I think I'm gonna take my time, right? I wanna make something that looks really good or that is very particular, very special. And then I'm gonna share that with you for free. So one thing you need to do is subscribe, okay? So next video, I'm probably gonna be sharing that there. And ring that notification bell and make sure it's not on personalized, but it's on all. It's free. Go to the website, polypoplive.com. Download it, try it out. Look at all of the options that you have, the presets, the 3D stuff, the 2D stuff, the filters. It is definitely pretty special. Make sure you do all the tutorials when you first install it, and I'm sure you will be impressed by all the possibilities that this thing has. Look at that. If I'm doing a giveaway, I can pick a viewer and then even show their profile picture if I wanted to. But as I said, I will be making more tutorials. Make sure you keep an eye out. Huge thanks to Polypop for sponsoring this video. I am slowly doing my transition from OBS and all those services to Polypop so that it can actually be my live streaming software. But in the meantime, I'll say thank you so much for watching this video. I will see you on the next one. Go out there, make me proud, get level, out.